In this video today, we're going to deal with a GE dryer that is making noises during operation. It heats, it turns on, it runs, but it's not just a normal tumbling noise. It doesn't sound good. And let me tell you guys to be very serious. Among any dryer on the market, if a GE like this or the older models is making noise, you have to get it dealt with and solved very quickly, because if you don't fix it, it can turn into a very simple into something that's very disastrous that will end up ruining the dryer. We see it quite often where it makes a noise and then we can't even fix it, or the cost is nearly a new dryer. So let's get to how to fix this and tear it down. You should only need a screwdriver to get to most of this, but you could also use a drill gun with a few different bits to make this job go a whole lot faster. So let's get this apart on this newer style GE and figure out what's making it sound bad. The first thing I would look for is bearing or door damage to your unit. Open the door and inspect the inside of the door where the plastic meets the metal. If the noise has been going on for a long time, it's possible you'll see damage here. For comparison, here's an older GE dryer that the bearing is separating from the door. If the bearing is damaged to the point where the metal dryer drum is rubbing on the metal door, it can cut through and create sharp edges between the bulkhead and drum. If you see a sharp edge, then you need an entire new door assembly. Now for the next steps, we're going to get inside the dryer to look at some pieces on the inside, so go ahead and unplug the unit from the wall if it is still plugged in. Now let's go ahead and dig into the front of the dryer. There are two screws on the rear of the chassis, one on each side that needs removed with a Phillips head screwdriver. Now at this point you could get a picture of the wires and then remove all the wires from the top of the console to take the wire trunks off the rear of the dryer to access the front, but even though some videos tell you to do this, you don't really have to do this to access the front of the GE dryer. Let's go ahead and skip ahead and take the two screws out of the front of the dryer here. You'll use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove both of these screws, one on the left, one on the right inside the door. You can then take a screwdriver to pop the top of the dryer. You can angle it ajar slightly to either side, and this will let you look in and see if the belt on the drum is damaged or shaved in any way. On some models of GE dryers, there's going to be a light switch harness on the left side at the top as you see here, but not all do. You'll need to press into the harness and then remove it. Now there are two hex head screws, one on each side of the dryer, that need taken out. Once you have both of these removed, you can then pull on the door to get ready to remove it. But this is the most difficult part, I think, of dealing with a GE dryer. To remove the door, you need to simply pull up on it to get it off the three fingers at the bottom of the dryer. However, the wire harness for the door lock will prevent you from moving this door very far away from the unit. The wire harness to the door lock is very short. You can carefully move the door to the left side and then remove the harness, but the one way that may be a little bit easier is to angle the door forward and rest it on a heavy box, or use a chain to hold the door at an angle so it doesn't fall too far forward off of those hinges at the bottom. This will give you access to the wire harness from the rear. Either way, you have to move the horribly designed plastic cover to the side, then press into the harness and remove the wire harness from the door switch housing. If you split the door to the side, it uninstalls the same way, and it's your choice on how to handle it though. But at either rate, once the harness is removed, you can remove the door and move it aside away from the unit. Note that some models of GE dryers have the door light switch down where the door harness is, and some of them don't. With the door off, grab the drum and lift up slightly. Begin to rotate the drum, listening for any noises that could be causing the issue with the door now fully off. This will help isolate where the damage could have possibly occurred so far. If the belt and pulley are still in place, you should see the blower housing move and rotate. Check for any lint or debris in this area that could cause noise, or something that could have jammed in the blower housing that would be the source of your issue. Once the drum is out, we're going to inspect it if needed. Alternatively, if the bearing or sleeve behind the drum is bad, you may want to unhook the belt and idler system and rotate the drum and hear for the noise, just the drum itself, which would isolate that as being the culprit. Now let's go ahead and take the drum to the dryer out. We have to remove the idler pulley first, which is directly behind the blower motor housing. This dryer does not have a ton of room for your left hand, but quite a bit for your right, and that's the one you want to focus on.
From the camera view on the inside to the right, this is what you're going to see. You can use your right hand to pull the pulley to the right, and the secret is if you pull far enough, there's a little tab on the motor mount of the unit that you can hold the idler pulley in place to remove the belt. The metal of the pulley can rest here, allowing you to have an easier time to release the belt from the idler. Here's another angle of that same action, but I didn't actually realize that this unit had that little mounting part. You want to make sure that the belt is removed from where the motor mount is, so even though it's loose, you need to move it away from that metal pulley that is on the motor. Otherwise, when you try to pull the drum out, it could snag on the belt mount like you see here. I was so focused on getting the right camera shots, I didn't realize that the belt was going to snag. Whoops. Now, if you didn't take the entire top and console off, the best way to take the drum out is to angle the back of the top of the dryer against a wall slightly like you see here. It will rest the console and the top, and you can put a box to hold it in place so it doesn't get too far away. This will allow you to take the drum out or put it in quite easily. Use the belt when it's free of the pulley and motor to pull up and then out on the drum. The metal sides of the dryer have little grooves in them that will show you kind of like the shape of the drum so you can pull it out directly. If you pull up too far or too low, it won't be within that little oval. It'll rub on the sides or make a noise when it comes out. With the drum out, you can inspect the inside for anything that could cause noise. I would look for dirt and debris that could rub up against the drum or motor assembly from this stage of the video. Now inspect the rear of the bearing for damage, rust, pitting, or anything that could cause noise. This is very rare to go bad, but it can in fact happen. Also, if it's extremely dry, you do need a lubrication, a lithium or bearing grease to lightly coat it, and if that's missing, it could possibly cause the noise. Inspect the bearing cup on the inside as well for damage, much like the bearing shaft itself. Again, this is rare to see damaged, but it's pretty easy to check, and if you need a replacement for the bearing or the bearing shaft, we will have a section in the description that will have a link to all the parts we use in this video for potential replacements. Now, if you want to take the blower off to clean the inside, here's how you would do it. It's a little complex though. Remove the door wire harness assembly away from the blower housing by pulling it through the plastic square you see here. Then take a 1/4-inch hex head screwdriver or drill gun, then proceed to remove the 11 screws on the metal plate that hold the front on. Then using a Phillips head screwdriver or drill, remove the one screw on the bottom, then the two long black screws at the top of the blower housing as you see here. Note that there's not enough room to take the cover off yet, even though we've taken off so many screws. Behind the motor now are 3/4-inch hex head screws that need removed from the motor plate. Then go ahead and remove the idler pulley. Simply pull up on the back side of it as you see here, and there is a compartment it slots out of at the front of the motor, and we'll show that too in a minute. Finally, there's one hidden screw on this side of the dryer motor. Use a screwdriver to gently unscrew the 1/4-inch hex head that is a grounding screw, and then put that one to the side. With all of these things done, you can easily push the motor back 1 or 2 inches. This will allow you to pull the entire cover off or remove the entire motor assembly if you needed to. To remove the front of the blower housing, just pull it forward and then to the right where the plastic fingers are. This will allow you to check for anything that could have obstructed that blower cage or any other issues that could have caused damage to the blower motor system inside the housing. If you have a vacuum cleaner, you can go ahead and clean this out, but the housing is not in terrible shape in this particular unit. I would go ahead and start by putting the cover back on and putting 2 screws into place. The cover will love to fall off if you try to do any of the other steps before putting at least 2 screws in. Press the motor and blower housing towards the front of the chassis so it locks the plate's fingers into the dryer chassis. Here's another view of the chassis and what these fingers look like when they are locked into place. Next, slot the idler pulley into place. Make sure it seats into the metal finger that's on the motor housing. There is a finger on the rear side where the plastic pulley is that holds it into place. And then on the back side of the idler, there's a small hole in the motor housing for the arm to catch onto, and hopefully this shows you what it looks like. Then go ahead and line up and reinstall the 3 screws into the motor plate that's near the rear of the drum, then the single ground screw that is near the belt switch, which you see me screwing in here. Then go ahead and install all the screws into the front of the blower housing. 2 long black Phillips head screws on the top of the housing, 1 slightly longer Phillips screw at the bottom of the dryer chassis. Then you have to install the rest of the 11 short hex head screws that can be installed in any order. One thing I did notice that screwing them in that goes from the chassis to the blower housing on the left side were kind of difficult. You may want to only partially insert all the screws and then go around and slightly tighten them in just to make sure everything will fit into place. Now let's look at the door that you removed earlier in the video. On the top, there are four plastic slides and then some felt pieces. Each of these need inspected for wear and damage. If the plastic glides are damaged or even worse, missing, this will absolutely cause a ton of noise with the dryer. If the glides have been damaged for a long period of time, the drum could start wearing through the plastic bearing itself, slowly damaging it to where replacing the glides will not be enough, and you would need then a top plastic bearing housing. On the lower half of the door, you have felt and a lower plastic bearing, and it's the same steps for these. Make sure everything is securely in place with the felt. Often, if the bearing glides have been damaged, the plastic could scrape against the drum, causing noise. This is actually the most common area where the GE dryer will make noise, is on those top glides or the bearing itself. And if you need any of those, I will have a link to them in the description. Now, another thing that we kind of glossed over earlier was the idler pulley and the belt combination. Make sure the pulley can move freely. There should be some bearing grease on the metal arm of the idler. Sometimes the plastic pulley can develop flat spots that could cause the belt to rub on a section, causing noises or difficulty with the unit running. So if that pulley looks damaged, I would replace it. Sometimes you can replace the whole assembly or just that pulley itself. Make sure also the belt isn't frayed and is in good condition. These are all the major steps I would look for and inspect on a GE dryer that's making noise. The key here is to isolate what particular item could be causing the noise, going piece by piece when you take it apart, and then solve it. Now let's go ahead and put the unit entirely back together and close the video out. Let's go ahead and put the drum back in for testing. Remember the idler pulley trick earlier? I would go ahead and pull it and have it set on the motor housing before we put the drum in. The drum has two grooves in it. Make sure the belt rests on the rear one where the black outline of the belt is. If yours is slightly different, it may be in a different position though. Angle the top of the dryer back against the wall like we did when we took it out. Place something to hold the top up, and then go ahead and take the dryer drum by the belt and slide it into place. The bearing on the rear of the drum should go in straight into the back of the bearing housing. Turn the drum slightly to make sure there aren't any obstructions or any weird noises that would suggest that it didn't get put in right. On the right side of the drum, this is what I see and how I need to put the idler pulley back into place by releasing the tension. But before you do that, make sure the belt is wrapped around the motor pulley properly so that when you release that tension, it goes on perfectly. This process could take a time or two to get right, but hopefully the camera kind of explains the mystery of the process. With the drum in place, you should be able to gently turn it and see the blower housing move along with the belt so everything here is engaged properly. You can also listen to any obstructions that could cause or suggest something didn't get installed right. Now go ahead and put the door back on. The bottom of the door is going to rest on these three metal fingers on the dryer chassis. Set the door onto the fingers and then pivot the door forward to the bulkhead. I would go ahead and rest something on the door front so you can reinstall the door lock at this point. Move the stupid plastic cover out of the way. Reinstall the door switch harness into the door like you see here. Hopefully the plastic cover doesn't snap and slash you in the fingers like they like to do on GEs. When you pivot the door into place, you're going to have to get the bearing of the drum to rest on the door frame. This can be a little bit difficult, so you may have to open the dryer door and wedge it into place by moving the drum against the bearing, but it will seat into place. When you put the front of the door on, also make sure to notice that there are metal tabs on the inside of the door and on the sides of the chassis of the machine. These little fingers need to line up to make sure the chassis gets aligned properly. If you did anything to bend or warp the door slightly when working on the machine, it may not fit into place, which could make it look like the door just won't go back on. But once you have the front on, go ahead and insert the two short screws back into the top left and top right sides of the dryer. Both of these are 1/4-inch hex screws. If your door light harness was on top like mine, you'll need to go ahead and insert it back into place. Next, you'll want to secure the top of the dryer to the chassis. It needs brought forward and snapped into place. The rear is off a little bit, but we can get that adjusted easily off camera. With the top kind of secure, you can actually just go ahead and test the dryer to see if what you did worked. Plug the dryer in and see what happens. In the case of this dryer, we actually fixed the unit perfectly. It's running great. There's no noise from it at all. It's operating fine, and we haven't even actually put it all back together. And if you didn't do the installation processes to this point right properly, then you may have overlooked a wire harness and need to go back and check, or there's another difficult problem that this video sadly does not cover. Let's go ahead and finish putting the dryer back together though. Take the two long Phillips head screws and reinsert them to the top part of the dryer door. This will secure the top part of the dryer to the front of the cabinet. Now go ahead and insert two identical screws at the rear of the unit, one on left, one on right side. If you had unplugged any wires, go ahead and reinstall them at this point, but we did not. To get the console snapped back into place, the six fingers need slotted into these holes properly. You'll then pivot the console back into place and then tap on the rear of the console to push it forward to lock it into place. Before putting the metal back on, you need to reinsert the ground screw with the ground wire from the inside going to the outside. It's a quarter inch hex head, and when you have that done, there's a small metal finger on the left back that needs slotted into the plastic console. Then go ahead and slot the right side into place. It was bent a little bit, so I had to bend that with my screwdriver. Once that's done, you're going to install the four screws on the metal housing, right side and left. The last step now is to just install the two top hex head screws that go down in from the console into the metal top of the dryer, one on the right, one on the left. These are all the major fixes that you'd want to take doing your dryer, and now it's back to being fully assembled. I hope this video helps you out. All the major parts that we looked at for this dryer are going to be in the description of the video. Now, if you click on the links and purchase the parts through those links, it does help me buy more appliances to test, review, and fix. I also have two or three other videos on this exact GE dryer that we shot all at the same time. This video should now be displaying on the screen, so if you have any more questions, they may be able to help you. Have a great day.